What is going on, guys? It's your boy DFastX, and I'm back with another Star Wars review. This is on Disney Plus show Andor Season 1. Before I do the video, if you're here to see more about exciting videos from new to this channel, smash that subscribe button, click the bell icon, and drop the likes. So I watched all 12 episodes of this series, and I also got to say, guys, this was a really good Star Wars show. I absolutely enjoyed Andor Season 1. Guys, Andor is such a great Star Wars series, and I absolutely enjoyed every episode of this series. So, what the story is about, this is kind of the story of before Rogue One, where Andor, this is kind of like how the rebellion started and stuff, and how the Empire can be just nasty assholes in this freaking series, and it explains that, like, how they're just so nasty and stuff when you watch this series. So it's about catching Andor. He's on the run from the Empire, of course, and so because in the first episode, when you can see, he shot like one or two of their lieutenant people on a planet or something, so he's on the run and stuff, and the Empire's hunting for him and stuff. So He's now been offered by people to try to stay hiding and stuff. So he meets this guy in this picture, Luton Rayne, played by Stellan Skarsgård, which I've seen him in the Marvel movies, in Dune, and also the Pirates of the Caribbean movies. And he tells Andor to hide. He takes Andor to a different planet to go to hiding while he's going to Coruscant. To meet Mos Matama, I think her name is, which you can see this picture right here. And so she's pretty good in the series, and we get to see her later in the stages of Rogue One and stuff, how her whole policies are all like kind of collapse and stuff when you watch this series. And you actually get to see Coruscant in this series again, which is really, really good and stuff. And so So while Andor is on this different planet, he's now trained. He has to be trained to disguise himself as one of the lieutenants of the Empire and stuff by doing the walk, and even doing the holding the guns and all that kind of stuff as well. And so story continues on then. Then he gets captured in this prison on Narkina 5, where he meets this character, played by Andy Serkis. I'm very bad for names, guys, but it's a. He plays this character called Kino, and Kino is he's obviously been in the prison for a long time and stuff. And I gotta say this, guys, Andy Serkis gave the best performance that I ever seen in Star Wars. And I just realized something, that he has played two Star Wars characters in the franchise. He's played Snoke in the sequel movies, and he's now playing one of these characters in the series and stuff. And Andy Serkis in this series, he's a great actor, and I've seen him in many movies, like a lot of movies and stuff. He's done a lot of the CGI characters, like War of the Planet of the Apes and stuff. He played Claw in Black Panther and stuff, and lots more. He's just an amazing actor. He gave the best performance in one of the episodes when you watch it and stuff. And so, eventually, then Andor, he gets off, obviously gets off, escapes like Narkina 5, and. Now when you watch Andy Serkis' character, it doesn't really end well for him, because it's a little plot twist when you watch it and stuff. But so Andor has now escaped, and of course I forgot to mention as well, in the series you actually get to see his backstory and stuff, and how a woman named, I forget her name now, but his mother anyway, had brought him in and adopted him and stuff. And so what happens is that you actually get to see what actually happens to his mother in this series, and it's really, really sad. And even when I see Cassie Andor in this series, that you can see him getting very, like, you know, how emotional he is when he hears about his mother and stuff in this series. And it's really, really good. And I forget the actor who plays Cassie Andor, but he's acting in his perfection in this and stuff. And so the last episode then. The last episode, I just gotta tell you this, guys, you're gonna love it. You're gonna love the last episode, and very creative what they're doing in it. It's just going to be epic. And how you see the entire people of the planet, of the planet where Andor is staying, fighting the Empire. Because I tell you this, guys, the Empire are just nasty bastards. They're just absolute nasty bastards in this series. And guys, I just absolutely enjoyed it. Now, guys, just to let you know that there is a post-credit scene of this. That it's not something new. I wouldn't say it's really something new. It's basically just a thing you probably see, probably like a thing that you've seen before in the previous Star Wars movies and stuff and all. But overall, guys, I absolutely enjoyed Andor Season 1, and I'm so excited for Season 2 in 2024, because I heard that they're going to film it in a few weeks' time and stuff, so I can't wait to hear about that. So overall, guys, I give it this series a 9 out of 10, 5 stars. Guys, all 12 episodes are on Disney Plus right now. Go watch it. It's such a great Star Wars series, and I can't wait for Season 2, 2024. So that is my review of Andor. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. The next one I'll be doing is the Guardians of the Galaxy Holiday Special. So stay tuned for more of my video, guys. Smash the subscribe button, click the bell icon, and drop the likes. And I'll see you next time. Peace.